Howdy, folks, and welcome once more. Let's stick around and escape from Tarkov. Today we are in Interchange, and I think I actually know where we are. We're on, like, the north chunk of the map, northeast corner, out by the power plant? What are our exits? What do we have? Scav camp, hole in the fence, safe room, and Emmercom. Alright, I do have a map for this open because I'm bad. But we'll see. We'll see how this works. We'll poke around a little bit. I want to test out the new gun. I did get flashlights for both the M4 and my handgun, just to be safe, because it is dark in there. But aside from that, it's just the typical stuff here. I feel like maybe I need to, dink around with my sensitivity here a little bit. Specifically, mouse sensitivity while aiming. Let's bump this up to like 0.5. Oh my god. 0.51, fine. Just. Yeah, that feels better. Okay. And this is nice and spastic. This is still spastic, but I still feel like I have control. It was too sluggish otherwise. Alright, so. There's a bunch of shit all over the place in this map. I know that much. I was watching the server logs as it generated, and there's like 300 items, like 300 loose items on this map, so. Tentatively shit everywhere. I'm very thankful for the all-in-one mod having fixed that. And like, reflexively, I come to this book. This is just art from the game. I love it. Escape from Tarkov in Escape from Tarkov on this word magazine. But I see a magazine and my brain immediately ferrets over to Fallout and I'm like, oh, I should take that. It'll probably give me skill buffs. And I realize that this game doesn't work quite like that. Did I just... Were those croutons? Okay, we actually need these. I think it's... Jaeger wants those? Amelia Rye croutons. Amelia Rye croutons, nice! Alright. One of three. Yeah, I wanna poke around in here. But first... But first, I want to search these cabinets, but with that door open, it's just asking to get shot, so let's do this instead. Oh, what do we got? Question, ooh, new key, nice. I'll take it. Nothing else. Alright, well, we got a key out of it, I suppose. I don't think it's really dark enough in here specifically to warrant using a flashlight, but I'd be curious to know if it blinds AI the way that it'll blind a player. I would assume it doesn't because the AI is the AI, but still it would be cool if it did. I'd be curious to see what like nailing, like somebody using night vision goggles, nail them in the face with a flashlight. I'm curious how the game would handle that level of blindness. I wonder if it would actually like affect them in such a way as to be worth doing. Probably not, because if I had to guess, people at that range would be probably just picking you off before you even knew they were there anyways. Man. Paranoia. We haven't even gotten into the main building yet. And I'm already afraid of everything. I don't really have any items to be collecting right now. I mean, I'm sure there's things that I need, but I have no idea what they are. We're like taking nuts and bolts and stuff. It'd be cool if you could like have like a notes section like in here, like next to tasks say, and it's just like literally a notepad where you can write shit on it. That would be convenient. Ooh, a tool set. I'm keeping that. Because normally if you want a tool set, you've got to barter with mechanic for it. So for free? Absolutely. Screw nuts and a fancy screwdriver, sure. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. I don't suppose there's any reason to go up. Does not look like it. All right. Well, I'd say we're done in here. Or exits. All right, railway? No. Scout camps on the west side. Hole in the fence is actually just to the south of us. Amercom is farther south. And the safe room exfiltration is... looking at the map in the garage? But it says it requires something. You have to activate something. The text is too small for me to read with my aging vision. It sucks. I remember when I could see good, and now I'm getting old and need glasses, and I hate everything. Never get old, kids. Never get old. That's the best advice Pappy Ghost will ever give you. Figure out a way to halt the passage of time. Oh, shit. Apparently we also have the, power plant exit is open to it. Oh, no, it is. Okay, I see that. I wish it would always just tell you what you need, like, once you've discovered it. Because, like, I'm a forgetful dope. It's like, all right, I need 3,000 rubles. You might be able to scrounge that up. There are a lot of... Oh my god, I can't even word. Turnstiles in there, not turnstiles. Fuck! Cash registers, Jesus! Fight off the dementia, too. That's another one that you need to kind of keep in mind as you grow older. Don't go completely insane. I've been told I should hold on to these. Whether or not I actually will is anybody's guess. Are these keys both the same thing? No, okay. Making sure, because I was going to pitch one of them up here if they were. Probably actually just drop one. Ooh! Now, some stock for something. Oop. Might be able to. Is this compatible with mine? No. Darn. Alright, well, shit's kicking off, so I should probably not be just standing with my back to the world. I'm getting, like, super paranoid. I keep, like, seeing people moving where there are no people. Smokes, honestly. Don't care too much about those. The goodies in there. Oh, there's goodies in there. Can we breach this? I see the loot box. So, yeah, there's, like, totally shit in there. So people that know more about this game than me, like, doors like this? Like, I can obviously get in here, because there's loot boxes. So, when it comes to breaching doors, how does it work, mechanically? Do I have, like, just a percentage chance to breach the door? Or if I have, like, a strength of a certain value, do I just always breach the door? How does that work? Please explain, people that know how this works. I appreciate you. Oh, what was that? What was that? Oh, close the door. Not quite what I wanted. Alright, I need to... we need to get away from this area. I've turned this zone into my binky, and I need to not. Okay, how do I want to approach this place? Like, looking at this. So this is the idea store up here. And then Ollie's down at the end. So I guess... I don't know. Freedom is, like, right down... right down there. I'm mostly just afraid of everything. Like, I hear movement, and it's probably just me. I'm sure people are screeching, like, just put on the headphones, you dipshit. Nah, they feel like cheating. Yes, I know they exist in the real world. I've actually used them at work, but they're not nearly as good as the ones that are here. They're good, like, weirdly so if you're not used to it, but I don't know. Part of me feels like they've kind of, like, regular hearing in this isn't as good as it should be. I don't know. See, this right here, this is why we have the flashlight. Because otherwise it's just darkness, and who knows what's lurking in there. But with the flashlight, we can see. Alright. I just want to see if there's any, like, loose containers out here or anything. Because I'm actually not super familiar with this map. Like, the outskirts I'm okay with for the most part. But, like, inside these buildings... unknown hellscape. And the complete lack of gunfire scares the shit out of me. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, I'm sure that this place is just crawling. I mean, we've seen how it is. Like, when we've done... like, when we did that scav run in here last season. And it was just... bad guys everywhere. And I'm pretty sure PMC spawns and stuff are working properly, I think. I don't believe they're busted. And even if they are, I think the AI mod would fix them. I don't know, I'll have to look. And see where values are sitting. So my goal here, and why we're moving through here instead of going into the store, is I'm like working us down towards the south side of the map. So that when it comes time to extract, we'll be in the proper area. Realistically, I think we've got a long way to go, because like this right here is the, alright, the Hamel building or whatever it is. Man, somebody in here is having fun and it ain't me. So... my assumption is that, much like in nighttime situations, the AI is not affected by it being dark in here. So I'm also going to work under the assumption that the AI is not able to perceive flashlights, like the light, the cone of light from them. So like where a player will see a flashlight and be like, oh, there's somebody in here with me. The AI is just going to be dumb and not realize that. That's my hope. Okay, and this thing's sighted out to 25 meters. Is... alright, I need to check really quick. Is the sighting... okay, the sighting is unique to each scope. That's actually really handy. So if I switch over to my long range, that one's sighted out to 50 meters. My nose keeps itching, and every time I have to take my mouse off to itch it, I'm like, oh, this is when somebody's gonna pop out and just cap me. That's small arms fire, that's a handgun. A shitty handgun. Okay. Just kinda... keeping my eyes open here. I'm sure we are going to get ganked. And I'm probably gonna get jump scared and be bitchy about it. Okay. That is a pile of sandbags. I hate it. I have, like, the biggest love-hate relationship with this map. I love this map, but I hate this map so much. Aw, man. I'm curious how the AI in this perceives sound, like whether or not it does. It has to. So if I recall correctly, the basement of this place is a killing field. I know that there are a bunch of AI spawns down there and there's all kind of goodies. So we are probably going... we're probably going to try to avoid the basement where possible. Yeah, I thought that was a dude. Pro tip, it's not. Can we get in the bathrooms? We can totally get in the bathrooms. Guys got any of them there hand sanitizers? This is like, why? Why can you come in here? There's nothing in here. But you can still come in here. Who's gonna be that one dude that comes in here and camps the bathroom for like 30 minutes of this match? Cause this is what, 45 minutes I think that we're in here. Ooh. Staff only. Theoretically, I'm staff, just not necessarily here. Guys hiding anything fun? Not looking like it. Alright. There's like gunfire down to the right here. I think now we are making our way south to the Ollie store. I swear, this is like something out of Fear right here. It's pretty good. Door's closed. This also gives me like almost Arma vibes. Kind of really quickly scanning tables here to see if there's any goodies hidden. There are not. There's a jacket. Man. And it's not even a searchable one. And like, I don't know if the AI comes back here or not. And that's like, I don't know. I hope one day that they can kind of expand where the AI treks around to make things a little bit more harrowing. Cause like, yeah, I might come back here, but they probably don't. My assumption is that the AI probably mostly sticks to like more open areas. I have a feeling that they probably don't work too well in tight quarters. Oh, there's gonna be bad guys. They're gonna be out. Yeah, I know where I am, I think. I have no idea where that's coming from. This sounds like something I don't particularly want to be on the receiving end of. Aw, man. I fucking love this game so much. I love this game so much as a single player experience. It's so fucking good. Like, the atmosphere is just great. Like, we're coming through here, it's dark. We know that there's bad guys. We don't know where they are. We just hear, like, gunfire in the distance. Ah, it's just choice. Like, no other game gives you this experience. Yeah, I don't think I didn't see that sitting there, by the way. What do we got? Aside from some pretty severely limited inventory space. Upper receiver, works on our M4. I'll take it. Okay, alright. telling you guys, this is like a fucking... like a horror game. It's wonderful. So where the hell am I? Am I in the, like, the southeast? I should be in, like, the southeast corner. This should be north, I think. This is not. This is north. Okay, so we actually want to work down this way. I think this is where I normally come in, right here, is that door. I could swear I keep hearing movement. Over here, maybe? Totally! I don't know what this dude is doing. Oh, the worst sound effect. Woo! Guy, you wanna... Man, it must be nice being, like, invulnerable. That's a grenade. Flash grenade. Okay, how bad off are we? I was gonna say, yeah, we got gut shot, which is trouble, because we don't have food. Our leg is fucked. But aside from that, we're actually okay. So, painkiller. Oh my god, dude. This dude will not die. What is this invulnerability? Oh my god. Yeah, we gotta get out of here. I think it's through here. Should be. Oh, we just bled out. Man, it must be nice being able to just soak round after round like that. Holy shit. I'm not one to generally call this game out on its bullshit, but I'm calling out some bullshit there. Holy hell. Alas, yeah, that stomach shot. Like, as soon as we got nailed with that, we were done, sadly. Our thunderous several experience points. It's okay, we did get out of there with some stuff. We got some keys, we got that toolkit. We got... what else did we get? I don't remember what else we got. And most importantly, we get to keep our IFAC. Come on. Alright, so we did get two new keys. So that counts for something. How are we looking on this key tool? Alright, we got plenty of room left too, which is nice. And I don't think... yeah, none of these keys are limited use either, which is nice. Alright, so that's a quest item. This is just... something. Alright. Let us go into presets. Rifles. Actually, we don't need to do that, do we? Because, yeah, we've got Babby's gun just waiting to be used here. Only one extra mag, though. Mild disappointment. Let's get our medic. We got a Band-Aid, an Esmark, a hemostat. And, oh, we don't have any painkillers, so Vaseline it is. Okay, so that's heavy. Is this also heavy? That is also heavy bleeding. Need to get rid of these guys then, because those are just a waste of inventory space. Where did... Jesus Christ. Man, I wish if you, like, control-clicked something from in here, that it would... It's interesting our bandages are all... Oh, because I probably bought them on the, I probably bought them on the, black market. Flea market. There we go. So we got partial army bandages. Why? Okay, aside from that, though, what am I missing? Splint. We need splints. And I'm sure, yeah, I was gonna say, I'm sure she doesn't sell good ones yet. Got a couple more levels until then. And we gotta do this here. Salewa kits. It says find in a raid. I'm curious. Can I just buy them and it'll count? These are like super cheap. Super cheap by comparison. Yeah, 800. I should buy like a bunch of these because these are like... Yeah. I'll buy a bunch of these. There's a reason behind my madness, trust me. Okay, so can we do this? Turn in. Okay, so no, we do have to actually find them. Okay, I'm fine with that, but no. Because like these things are super cheap and they're better than the car kits. Oh my god, control left click should just put it in my fucking inventory. It's not hard. But yeah. Like, these are good med kits. And for, like, that cheap, I got to. There. So now we are set. We'll probably just be carrying these Salewa kits with us every time once our IFAC runs out. They take up more space, but honestly, I don't care over much. I don't think one square is going to make or break me. And if it does, I'll just drop the damn thing. So, all right, so sell all that. So Prepper, do I have to loot your shotguns? No, MP133. I'm just gonna buy a couple shotguns then. MP133, because like there are other quests I wanna do. Shotgun, expensive. How many did he want? Was it two or three? I think it was two. It is, in fact, two. All right. Sure. Give me two. Thanks, Jaeger. You're making things easy for me, bro. Do this. Turn in. Turn in. Complete. All right. Yeah. Okay. Checking. Old Brown's pocket watch. Throw a tank trick in factory. Alright. So we apparently... Maybe we have the key already. And this is the USEC temporary camp. Proper's come. Oh my god. Oh no. Ah! Don't want to deal with it. But we need to, because, again, we are like... Oh, and this will actually get us a compass as well. IMark 2 professional handheld compass. Versus... IMark 2 professional handheld compass that I paid for with my own dollary dues. Okay, do you have receive all? All these things that I care so much about. He says, shaking his head. Alright. I mean, it's a little extra currency, I suppose. There we go. What is this? Heavy duty backpack. Ooh! Ooh, shit. The only downside to that is that if we got like a gun that was particularly large, we wouldn't be able to fit it in it. Oh, hey, airplane noises. I'm sure that's nice and like blaringly loud. Well, we gotta buy the fancy glasses. Expeditionary fuel tank. It does have fuel in it. I'll buy one. That looks like about it. Okay, we are going to need to arm ourselves here a little bit. We've got some stuff. Okay, we're not going to be able to wear this, so I'm going to buy us a helmet. Crappy helmet. We'll get better eventually. I'm not worried. And we are going to need a hand cannon. Where is it? There's my hand cannon. And two of these. Come on, game. Take my money. Game. Oh, this is worrisome. Huh. Okay. Let's unload this. It's the ammo. It's getting to be the point where I'm gonna need to buy more ammo soon. Mostly because I keep dying with it, but the way of things. Okay, do I have grenade? Nope, Vaseline. These are the Katakovkas? Yes, okay. Removed warhead. Good damage though. Alright, interesting. Let's close out of everything. Go to the hideout. I'm gonna throw this fuel into our generator. I don't know that there's any particular point in running it at this point. Eventually we'll have like a Bitcoin farm or something and that'll like passively earn us money, but that's a ways away. So we need to upgrade our security, need to upgrade our vents. Water collector construction is complete. Install. Yay! We get more hydration. Med station. Oh. Shame it takes. Can we craft these? Are we allowed? I think. Raid or craft? Alright. So I need Esmark. Okay. Does she sell painkillers? She does. Alright, give me 4. And then 4 bandages. I think it's 2 of these. And I need a... Is that hemostat? Yes? Hemostatic? Which, it's probably going to pull the one out of my inventory, but I also have extras. Okay, so can I make this without fuel? Well, the generator has fuel. Thank you very much. Oh my lord. Turn on the generator. Jesus. It'll get there. It just takes it a minute. It's got to spool up, okay? High action gameplay. Alright. Start. Auto. Hand over. Yay! Look at that! So I hope that once I close down the server that this will keep running and it's not going to have to require like 33 minutes of playtime. I don't think it will. But I hope it doesn't. I don't think it will. See, I don't know. Whoa, hey camera, what are you doing? Can we upgrade anything else? Bunch of light bulbs. Bunch of wiring. Very expensive. We can't upgrade the generator. Nutrition unit. Now we can make food and stuff. That's cute. Eating is just extra energy regeneration. Stamina. Stash. Workbench. What can we do? What is this? A magnet. All right, good talk. Looks like we can, is that an AK? Fucking AKM, and we can just turn them into weapon parts. Interesting. Make gunpowder, make computer parts. Buckshot. It feels like there could be a better way to do this. Like, this is just like a big damn list of shit to go through. Give me like just a text list or something instead of just having like this massive ass thing right here. I don't know. Okay, so. Okay, so we can upgrade a shitty AK to a slightly less shitty AK. Interesting. I'm never going to do any of this. I can all but guarantee that. That having been said, I do think I'm going to go ahead and call it here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. Hope you had a good time, and I will see you all next time. We're in, I don't know, maybe more Interchange. Until then...